crypto XRP has been going parabolic over the last day or so. Look at it now, up 24% to 48 cents. As there are some developments in the legal battle between Ripple and the Securities and Exchange Commission. Here to discuss all of the latest developments, Ripple CEO Brad Garlinghouse and our own Charlie Gasparino. Charlie.
Thank you.
Brad, good to see you.
Before we get into this, your continuing saga with the SEC, Jamie Dimon called crypto a decentralized Ponzi scheme yesterday before Congress. Why don't you react?
I read that. I think very notable people, including Jamie Dimon, have called it a fraud. Warren Buffett, I think, had some negative comments.
Right.
I think we've reached a point where we know this industry is not going away. It's here to stay. You're talking about $1 trillion of value. And I think ultimately these things, as we've talked about here on this show before, are going to be measured by what utility, what problem are you solving? And so, for him to call it a Ponzi scheme, there's 50 million people here in the United States who have direct exposure to crypto that might disagree with him.
Well, let's get to XRP because the Twitterverse is going nuts over your appearance right now on Fox Business with Charlie. And XRP, of course, the native coin to the Ripple. Tell me exactly why you think that this jump in price is happening. What news can you give us?
Like, it's hard to know. Honestly, I've watched crypto now. I've been in the business at Ripple for 7.5 years. I've been in crypto for about 9 years. It's really hard to know. What I would point to is a couple things. Before the SEC got involved
with you guys,
with us and ETH, because again, there's two factors here. One, XRP was the second most valuable digital asset ahead of ETH. And then around 2018 was a kind of a famous, now infamous speech that kind of anointed
of the corporation finance.
And so look, I think increasingly as the summary judgment filings were made public, people realized that maybe the SEC really is overreaching. They really aren't following a kind of faithful allegiance to the law. And that's a quote from the judge in this case. And so I think people are realizing that,
the judge said that it might be. They might not be, right?
No, but the judge said is, one, the SEC is being hypocritical.
Yes.
And two, they said that they were not following a faithful allegiance to the law in pursuit of an outcome. And I think that's what we have here. The SEC, I think, has kind of lost its way. I said yesterday on stage, I think it's cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
I was going to ask you that.
We have to remember the SEC gets its power from statutes passed by Congress. Congress gives the SEC power. The SEC can't just take power. What the power says today, for the 1933 Securities Act, said that you have to have an investment contract. So as you'll see in our motion for summary judgment, the first step of determining it could XRP be a security is you have to have an investment contract. And our point is Ripple doesn't have a contract. Whom is the contract? It's not a written contract, it's not an oral contract, it's not an implicit contract.
So where we are right now in the case?
So the summaries for motions for summary judgment were just filed last week. They were made public on Saturday, which I'll mention very briefly. We had agreed with the judge and with the SEC to release those on Monday. They jumped the gun. And it's just this constant, I think, disrespect to the court process, and which we've seen time and time again. The judge in this case has ruled 5 different times that the notes associated with that infamous speech we're talking about should be turned over to Ripple.
And they didn't
We still don't have them.
So the case, she's going to make a decision on whether it goes to trial or not, or whether she'll just rule from the bench, right? So
I think we expect that there won't be a trial because trials and juries are really to determine if there's uncertainty about facts.
Right.
The facts here really aren't very much in dispute. The law is in dispute.
You think she's going to...
We think she has the information to make a ruling, and we think it's very clear that the SEC is grossly overreaching their authority.
Before we go, what is your relationship with this gentleman, Ryan, what's his name?
Ms. Smelkus.
Smelkus. What is this?
He calls me Garlic House. I call him Smelkus. His name's Ryan Selkis. He's a very smart guy.
He runs
Messari.
Messari, which is an information of crypto information service.
Yeah, exactly. He hosts right now in
New
York City.
This is you dunking him.
Well, right? I cheated. The dunk tank, it turns out, is hard.
Yeah. Liz
is going to laugh at me now.
Well, it worked.
It did work.
Now, you guys have a love-hate thing going, right? More hate?
As we have talked about, people's persona on Twitter can be quite different than their persona in person.
Right, right.
And I think he's run a great conference, and he's part of the kind of conversation of how to bring crypto into the future.
So,
but he said some stuff on
Twitter.
So he's
kind of a jerk on Twitter.
That would be an understatement.
Oh, well, really?
You could go read. I mean, I don't know.
What do you call you?
I'm not. Safe space.
Charlie knows from jerks on Twitter.
By the way, I get trolled on Twitter a lot. And there was one guy, I don't want to say his name, we went back and forth on Twitter a lot. Now we're very close. We talk every day. I like
maybe that. Maybe Ryan Selkis and I have a bromance budding. We'll see.
Dinner, maybe?
Yeah. Charlie, the United Nations is on the phone. They want you to solve the Middle East crisis.
Okay. Yes, I'm there.
Thank you very much. Right. Brad, please keep us posted on the case.
We'll
Thank you very much.
Outside, I'm alone.